Coach, you knew it wasn't going to be easy with Texas close to within three late in the fourth quarter. What was your message to your defense?
Well, our message at halftime was we got to play for 60 minutes. You know, championship teams and teams that get to this point are going to be able to come back, and they certainly did, and that speaks well for the character of their team and their coaching staff. And, you know, they did a great job of coming back. I was proud of the way our guys bounced back out in the fourth quarter.
The first coach to win two national championships in two different schools. Allow yourself to. What does it mean to you?
Well, really what it means to me is I'm so happy for our entire team. You know, our fans who have been great ever since we've been in Alabama. The players, the great job that they've done is buying in to do what we need to do. Our coaching staff and everybody in the organization, our administration, Mal Moore, Dr. Witt, everybody has, you know, made a great team. And that's why this team is good. It's not just because of me. I'm proud of the team, and I'm proud of the way they play today. And I'm really proud of the state of Alabama and our folks that this means a lot to us. You get excited, you get back this fast. Well, I never had a timetable for it. We just try to do what we need to do every day from a process standpoint to get better, and I'm really proud of the way our guys competed today.
The process and now the results. Congratulations, Nick. Lisa Salters now.
Thank you, Tom. I'm with Texas quarterback Colt McCoy. Colt, what was it like for you to watch this game, your last game in a Longhorn uniform from the sidelines?
I love this game. I have a passion for this game. I've done everything I can to contribute to my team, and we made it this far. And it's unfortunate I didn't get to play. I'd have given everything I had to be out there with my team. But congratulations, Alabama. I love the way our team fought. Garrett Gilbert stepped in and played as good as he can play. He did a tremendous job. Always give God the glory. I never question why things happen the way they do. God is in control of my life, and I know there's nothing else. I'm standing on the rock.
What have doctors told you about the extent of your injury to your shoulder?
You know, I really have no pain in my arm. I just can't feel my arm. It wasn't a painful hit. I've taken that hit over and over my whole life playing this game. I know you're going to get hit. I guess I got hit the right way. You know, like I said, I'm not in pain. My arm's dead. You know, it feels like I slept in my arm, woke up, and it's dead. So, I don't know.
Well, it's been a pleasure watching you these last 4 years. Best of luck to you in your future, Cole.
Thank you. Congrats to Alabama. Tremendous football team.
Thank you. Let's send it over to Tom Rinaldi. Tom?
Thanks very much, Lisa. Here with Mark Ingram. Mark, I know it was a very, very difficult game for you. You're in the pain right now. Heisman Trophy National Championship. How do you describe the journey of this game?
The whole entire organization from the top to the bottom. That's all we work for. We set that goal at the beginning of the year, and we work for it. And we deserve it. I don't think anybody in the country works harder than us. And team played a great game today, and I got to give credit there to the entire team. It was a team effort. I couldn't have did it by myself.
I know your dad was watching you tonight. What message did you send him about your play?
Man, I love you, man. We did it. We did it. You're number one, baby. I love you.
He's a proud son to a proud father.